Hey Robot Makers, here's 5 things that you need to know about MicroPython. It's very easy to learn, and it's never too late to start learning. Python is about as close to plain English as you can get with a programming language. MicroPython is the same language as Python, with just fewer features so that it can fit on a small microcontroller. Python uses indentation to imply the structure of the code, as well as making the code easier to read. It means that there's no need for those funny symbols at the end of the code, such as the curly braces and the semicolon. So here's an example of 2 pieces of code side by side, one in C and one in MicroPython. So on the left hand side there, you can see that we have the curly braces at the start of the code block and at the end of the code block, and at the end of each line of code we need to have that semicolon to tell the compiler that that's the end of the code. Whereas on MicroPython there's no need for that. The indentation tells us whether this is part of a function or not, or whether it's part of the main code. We don't need to have those semicolons at the end of each line, which means our code just looks easier to read. The easiest way to get into MicroPython is to get yourself a development board, and these are really cheap and easy to come by. So I'd recommend either the Raspberry Pi Pico or the Microbit as a starter, or you can get the new Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect if you want to be really cutting edge. So number 4, it runs on loads of boards, like loads of boards. Here's a list of a couple of boards that I just happen to have on my desk. So there's the ESP01, the ESP8266, we've got the ESP32, we have the BBC Microbit, we've got the Raspberry Pi Pico, the Pimoroni Tiny2040, the new Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect, the Adafruit Circuit Playground Express boards, we have YPi, and we have the original Pi board. And that's just a few of them, there are lots more out there. So number 3, it's not the same on every device. MicroPython does have dialects. So the MicroPython that's on learn.microbit.org is slightly different than the MakeCode Python that's on makecode.microbit.org. That's the same site, and that's because one's Python and one's MicroPython, and they've just decided to do the libraries slightly differently. And then there's the offshoot from MicroPython that Adafruit have created that they call CircuitPython. And they would say that this is easier to use for new starters. Each board has more or less features, and that's usually made available through the machine library. And some boards have more flash than others. So for example, the Raspberry Pi Pico has 4 meg of flash on board, and the new Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect has 16 meg of flash RAM. And some chips are faster too. The Raspberry Pi Pico, for example, is much faster than the Microbit. And talking about speed, number 2, it's not as fast as C, but it's fast enough. So some coders will tell you that MicroPython is not as fast as C, and they are quite correct. So Python and MicroPython are interpreted languages, and that means that they are not compiled and optimized into machine code, but rather the code is interpreted line by line as it's executed on the board. Now for some applications this might be a deal breaker, but it's fast enough for most applications. The payoff is the readability of code, the ease of developing a raw machine code execution on the device itself. And certainly for beginners, this is not something that you need to worry about. It's more than fast enough for the kind of projects you'll probably be doing. And then number 1, it's growing fast, like really fast. Python is the world's most popular language right now, overtaking C and C++ and JavaScript as well. And this is true for MicroPython on embedded systems with a 6% lead over C. And it's ideal for AI and machine learning development. We have things like TinyML and TensorFlow Lite, which means that we can do machine learning, artificial intelligence on the board itself. So I hope you enjoyed this video and you click the subscribe button, and I shall see you next time.